Well, well. Then my ears didn't trick me after all. So, to what do I owe the honor? You didn't come to rob a helpless woman, did you? If so, think twice. These guardians were only a mousetrap, metaphorically speaking. Did she now? No, you don't seem to be lying. Well then, come on in. Who am I to dismiss a friend of my daughter? Sorry again for the guardians. I have reason to be cautious, let's put it that way. These parts of the land aren't exactly the coves of Calais, as you undoubtedly have known. Already. But it seems you know how to take care of yourself. Here we are. Welcome to my workshop. I would offer you something to drink, but you look as if you want to get straight to the point. So, tell me, what troubles my dear Erica so much that she affords herself a mercenary? As far as I know, this gallery of hers isn't exactly a gold pit. Which roughly translates as she needs new pictures because she has sold all the others. Poor girl. Business doesn't go so well, does it? She and her beloved Eshnu with their worried faces over a little pile of pennies? Oh, I can imagine it all too well. So let's make this short. The reason I haven't delivered has nothing to do with Erica. I have other problems to take care of at the moment, as I hinted at before. A robbery, to call the child by its name. One that has cost me a very precious piece. And... Actually, it's quite convenient that you're here. What do you say? You get me that picture back, and I'll do my best to send Erica new paintings as soon as possible. Oh, certainly. A good one. They were a young couple dressed in sinfully costly clothing and said they came to be portrayed. I should have gotten suspicious that they had no escort, but age makes you careless, I suppose. Anyway, I was just painting the pal when I felt a hit on my head. When I woke up, they were gone, together with a very dear painting of mine. I assume they ran for the Throatstone Quarry, at least judging from the trail, but it was already dark and despite all my magic, I have no desire to make acquaintance with hordes of lost ones or Vatiras. That's your job. I believe it is the question every successful artist asks himself sooner or later, isn't it? I have two answers for it. Number one, it is this place. The blood that was spilled here. It is as if a part of the body's soul soaked into the ground with it. These souls have become part of the forest now, as bones eventually become soil again. That, combined with the certain talent I possess, reflects in my paintings. They have... essence, if you can call it that. That's the romantic explanation. The other one is that the Ark Nobles simply love to look at themselves, and I have a hand for portraits. Good painters are hard to find. Oh, there are many reasons, none of which you would understand. Let's leave it at that. Oh, I get that a lot. One vial of child's blood, crushed dust maggot stingers, and dawnflower extract, well mixed up and regularly applied to the skin. I can only recommend it. Ugh, of course I am. Jokes aside, thank you for the compliment. hermit's life or not. Everyone likes to hear such things once in a while. I guess my looks just run in the family. I'm sure you will. Take care of yourself. I'll be right here. So, anything?
Thank you. First of the Golden Moon, 8233. I can't bear it any longer. Father, Malphus, fate, or whoever is listening. 16th of the Conquering, 8233. I'm going crazy. I'm going crazy, and they all know. Who are you? No, wait. Don't say anything. You're my punishment, aren't you? You're here to kill me. The faces. I just couldn't bear them any longer. I couldn't. None! First, I thought it would pass, you know? But it's just a disease, like the fever. But it didn't. It only got worse. First this strangeness, then the faces. This feeling that I wasn't myself, that Sister Pride, Nessa, is only a puppet who thinks she is real. Me, my name, before the Father showed me the Ralas. It started 2 years ago. Sometimes, when I talk to people, their faces began to run off, like color, like wax. At first, I thought I was ill, so I drank grunt root every day, but it never got better. Only worse. Everything started to melt. First the nose, then the eyes, then the mouth. Until there was nothing left but a smooth, egg-shaped piece of skin. Yes, it doesn't help with the strangeness, but at least I don't have to see faces anymore. No, of course not. Because nobody could find out. Had they found out, then the Father would have left me behind on the Day of Transcendence. And I couldn't let that happen. Don't you understand? I couldn't. Why? Because I was weak. angry and weak. I thought if only I fled far away from the Father, then the faces would return. But they didn't. Of course they didn't. Because I was the problem to begin with. My faith was too weak. My devotion to the Ralas too little. And that is why I need to die. I finally accepted it. But didn't the Father tell you to? No, there isn't. And even if there were, I wouldn't want it. This is my punishment. The punishment for my weakness. And if I had the courage, I would have already ended it myself. Everything. All this time. I was a bad Ralayim. I sinned. Again and again. I succumbed to my body, just as the sleepers do. And it corrupted my mind. I don't want to talk about it. Of course you don't, because you're a sleeper. If you want to help me, then help me sleep. And make it painless. Forgive me. 7th of the Fundament, 8233. Father, hear my prayer. Make me see them again. Make me see them.